Hi, I'm Fraser Douglas, the Avid Tent Camper. In this video, I'd like to share some of my opinions about using rope and cord in camp and show you how we use it to solve different problems.
We use small ropes and knots to secure rolled tarps, mattresses, and carpets, to tie gear onto the top of our luggage rack or trailer, to secure our tent and kitchen shelter against wind, to secure our tablecloth on the table on windy days, to make lanyards for axes, to hang lights inside of our tent and kitchen shelter, to make clotheslines, to make ridge lines for tarps, and many other tasks. Now, let me tell you about the cord that we specifically prefer. We always carry about 250 feet of 3mm utility cord. I like this particular size because it is relatively strong, being able to hold approximately 400 pounds, but yet it packs into a relatively small bag that can be packed into our tool bag. When possible, we try to buy PMI brand utility cord, which is available at REI and other Outdoor Outfitter stores. It is made from nylon and polyester, comes in a variety of colors, and sells for about $5 for a 50-foot pack. Sometimes you can find it with reflective threads that can be seen at night, but this cord may cost a little bit more. After buying about 4 or 5 packs of utility cord, I will cut at least 10 10.5-foot lengths and at least 10 more 5.5-foot lengths. Each time I cut the cord, I have to burn the ends to prevent them from unraveling. Then I tie a permanent loop on one end of each of these cords, making them either 5 feet long or 10 foot long. To keep these cords separate and organized, I hook the loops of all the 5 feet cord on one carabiner and all the 10-foot lengths of cord on a second carabiner. If I couldn't find the utility cord, I could use paracord instead, but paracord stretches more than the utility cord and bunches up when you try to push it through a hole. Paracord is available in several different sizes. Most bushcrafters like 550 paracord that is rated to hold 550 pounds, but the 425 paracord is closer to the 3mm utility cord that I like. In a pinch, you could buy some 1/8-inch utility cord from a home improvement store. In addition to the 3mm cord that we carry in our tool bag, we also have 6 thicker lengths of rope that we use to tie gear onto our car, onto our trailer, to hang hammocks, or to guy out our canvas tent when we pack it. So now let me start talking about knots that we use and begin with a few terms that will help describe how we tie them. The end of the rope that you're using to tie the knot is usually called the working end, and the other end, the distal end, that's usually attached to some tree or other object, is called the standing end. When you fold the working end of the rope back on itself, that is called a bite, and it is the first step in making an overhand loop. When you make a circle with the working end, that is called a loop. I'll begin with the overhand loop because it is the most common knot that we use. It should be considered to be a permanent knot because once you put pressure on it, it jams and becomes very difficult to untie later on. I tie these permanent overhand loops on every 5 and 10 foot length of cord that we have. We use this overhand loop to lasso clotheslines and hammock straps to trees, to make one end of our tent guy lines, to tie luggage on the top of our car, to tie tablecloths on top of our picnic table, to hang lights from the top of our tent ceiling, and for many other camp chores. To tie this knot, start with a 4 to 6 inch bite, depending on the size of your rope and the size of the loop you want to tie. Make a loop with this bite, then pass the bend of the bite under the two ropes and up through the loop, and pull tight. Since this jamming knot is difficult to untie later on, if you want to make a temporary loop, you can start the same as with the ordinary loop, but then pass the bend of the bite 2 times around the double line before tucking it under and up through the loop. If you want to tie an overhand loop through a tarp grommet, a tent loop, or through a hole in a piece of wood as shown in this photo, you can use a slightly different procedure. First, make a loop on the working end of your rope, and you'll need to make that loop higher than shown in this photo. Then pass the working end of the rope through the grommet hole or loop or hole in the piece of wood. Then bring the working end of the rope back up through the loop in the same side that it came out of the loop, and then follow that standing end around the turns of the loop. And you will have a neat looking knot attached to another loop. If you want to tie a loop that is just as strong as the overhand loop, but yet is extremely easy to untie when you're finished, then you should consider the bowline knot. The bowline is frequently named by outdoor enthusiasts as one of the most important knots to know. And many years ago, when we used to hang our hammocks with ropes, it was the knot that I used to hang hammocks. But now that we use hammock straps, we no longer use the bowline for any reason in our camp setup. Now I want to discuss the tautline hitch, because it is the second most important knot that we use. We use this tautline hitch to make the upper loop for all of our tent and tarp guy lines. It offers good resistance against strong wind, but yet is relatively easy to tighten or to loosen as needed. When properly tied, the tautline hitch provides just as much resistance against the wind as this little plastic slide that comes with many tents that are sold today. And we tie that tautline hitch high through the tent loop as shown in the U.S. Army Standard Operating Procedures Manual, rather than down at the ground around the stake as most people typically do today. To tie this hitch, first make a loop passing the working end of the rope over on top of the standing end. Then wrap the working end 2 times around the standing end, and then up the line toward the standing end. Then pass the working end under the standing end and back through the loop. When tightened, the hitch will hold firm to the rope, but will slide up or down with gentle pressure. We use a double half hitch in conjunction with an overhand loop when we want to secure equipment tight on our luggage rack, or when we want to make a tight clothesline or ridgeline. You begin by making a loop around a stationary object such as a tree, a pole, or the overhand loop. Then you make the first half hitch. Then you make the second half hitch. Then you tighten your knot down, and finally slide it around your stationary object. This double half hitch knot can also be used to make a temporary attachment point if your corner grommet pulls out. First, find a small, smooth stone, and then tie a double half hitch on one end of a short rope and an overhand loop on the other end. Put the stone under the tarp squeeze the tarp around it, and then place the double half hitch over the stone. Then slide the double half hitch knot around the stone until it closes tight. We use a sheet bend knot when we want to join two shorter ropes together temporarily to make a longer rope. Typically, we'll use it when we need to make a longer guy line to attach a tarp to a tree several feet away from the campsite. We usually tie our sheet bend knot to an overhand loop knot, but you could use just an ordinary bite and it will work just as well. Bring the working end of the white rope up from the bottom of the loop, make another small loop, pass the rope behind your overhand loop, and then back through the loop that you have made. Then pull tight. We use a square knot to secure rolled up tarps, air mattresses, carpets, and bundles of cord. When tying the square knot, just remember left over right, right over left. The trucker's hitch was designed to secure large bulky items onto a trailer or onto a luggage rack with a relatively short piece of cord. But we usually use a different system involving an overhand loop and a double half hitch to secure our load. To tie this trucker's hitch, you must first secure the standing end to a luggage rack rail or some other fixed point, throw the rope over the load, make a bite, and then make a loop with the bite. Then you run the working end of the rope around the opposite luggage rack rail, and then back to the loop, through the loop, pull tight, and then tie a double half hitch.
Well, I hope that you've enjoyed this little video, and I hope that it's given you some ideas about how you might be able to use rope and cord and knots a little more effectively in your campsite in the future.
For more information about modern tent camping history, equipment, procedures, destinations, and ethics, please visit my website. A link is provided in the description below.
Remember, take more trips, travel further, visit more attractions, and save money. Go tent camping!